Yeah, and I mean, it seemed like the host had no idea what the hell WWE even was. Because,
yeah.
I mean, if she's going into it thinking that, you know, well, they've got a CBA, you know, they're getting drivers driven, she didn't know what it was. It's not the UFC. And I don't know if UFC guys get that stuff. But she, I think, had a completely misinterpretation as to what the WWE even is as a business.
Well, that is the typical outsider's view, right? My God, I watch Bayley. I watch you every week on Raw and SmackDown, and I've seen you on WrestleMania, and I've, you know, see you on every pay-per-view. You must be a multimillionaire. Life must really be good. And when those fans begin to realize, and this is what I always tell the fans, when you buy that $30, $35 t-shirt on WWE.com, when you buy that franchise DVD or that ECW DVD, and I've asked tens of thousands of fans, so I know this is the answer. They believe that some portion of that is going to the talent. So if I buy a Bayley t-shirt, I believe 10, 12, 15, 20 bucks is going to Bayley, when in fact she might be lucky to be making 10 or 15 cents on that t-shirt. These are the things that I think that John Oliver, when he started with his show, and now we've seen Bayley on the Fox program, these are the things that the fans that support that product have to understand. You're enriching the guy at the top, and the rest of the people down the line are getting smaller and smaller crumbs as it goes down. It in my book, it's unforgivable. I've been around quite a while and seen a lot, and I just cannot for the life of me fathom why I would not want to protect my commodity, because my show is, you can call it whatever you want, my show is my talent, right? My sports entertainers, my wrestlers, whatever you want to term them. The last thing I want is to invest 52, 104 or more weeks in getting wrestler A, B, or C over and have that wrestler die in a car accident, traveling those 300 miles that Ben talked about earlier. Or worse yet, like we've seen how many times, die in a hotel room, self-medicating because of the injuries that they're going through or the depression they're going through from missing their kids' first words, first steps, first day of school. These are the things that the average fan really, it's time, I believe, in my big mouth way, it's time that we have that discussion with our fan base and with the media in general, like Fox Sports, and let them know exactly what is professional wrestling, what is sports entertainment, and what isn't it. Because, like you said, the woman that was running the interview with Bayley, she sure as hell seemed like she was on another planet when she was hearing these answers back from Bayley. And I think that says it all.
Yeah, Ben, when you dropped off, we just were saying that, you know, not only was it, I think Bayley kind of handled the questioning in a pretty decent way. You know, she's very well versed in that WWE PR world. But I thought that the people at Fox didn't smarten up the interviewer to the fact that what the WWE even is a business. I mean, I don't know what she thought WWE brought to the table in terms of just a business commodity. So that's what Shane was kind of addressing there at the end. But I'll throw this out to all three of you guys. John Oliver and the impact he had in that segment, it was the week before WrestleMania. So it had everybody talking. And WrestleMania was in the biggest market in the world. So everybody had the eyeballs on WrestleMania. But did John Oliver drop the ball by not following up? Kind of seems like he just went for the quick social media share.
Yeah. If I could jump in there for a second. Absolutely. You know, and I think when you look at his paradigm, right, we're going to talk about the three or four topics of the day, and tomorrow those topics are old hat. We'll go to the three or four topics for tomorrow. But what surprised me, and it shows you, again, the strength of professional wrestling, is that even, here we are 2-3 months later, and people are still regurgitating John Oliver's comments and attaching them to things like the Bayley interview. Clearly that there was penetration there to the fan base and to the general audience at large, you know, people that aren't wrestling fans. But like I said earlier, I think it's time that we have that discussion, what is and what is not fair for the wrestlers, and what should or shouldn't be the pay scale, the bennies on the side, because in every other industry, I cannot imagine Tom Brady or a Ben Roethlisberger jumping in a car after their game to drive 200 or 300 miles to the next game. Or, you know, somebody from the UFC, you know, having to go stay at the La Quinta, like Ben was talking about earlier, after their big battle at UFC 900. You know, but this is what still goes on, has always gone on in professional wrestling, and continues to go on because, again, I believe that the fans think that when they buy a Shane Douglas T-shirt, that the vast portion of that money is coming to me, or at least a good chunk of it, not tenths of pennies per T-shirt.